Welcome to the brand new episode of Virtual Teacher. I'm Bareera, working under the Department of Commerce, Sulam Aslam Science College. Today I'm going to discuss about what is Masala Bond. The Kerala government issued recently 2,150 crore Masala Bonds in London Stock Exchange, and it became a sensational and controversial news in the newspaper. So you are all know about that, what is a Masala Bond. In this slide, I'm going to discuss about what is a Masala Bond and how the mechanism of Masala Bonds work and why Masala Bond is so important. Let's begin. The Masala Bonds are the bonds issued outside India or foreign market in denomination of rupee. Or it's a bond or loan which we issued outside Indian market, like London market, Singapore market. And the main feature of that bond is that it's issued in rupee denomination. Okay, then why the term Masala used? It's just used because it's represent our culture, that we Indian peoples are like more masalas in our food. So IFC given the name Masala because we are people, because it's represent our or evoke our culture. So the term is used. There are so many country currency bonds or foreign currency bonds which are named after their culture or their nation. Like Japan's have samurai bonds, and China have dim sum bonds. So Masala is just a word used to represent our culture. So then why Masala Bond is so important? If a company want to borrow fund from the foreign market, they have two options to borrow fund from the foreign market. One, either they can issue foreign currency convertible bond or in the form of Masala Bond. When the company issue foreign currency convertible bond, the loan amount fully denominated into foreign rupees, or the loan amount, if we issue 500 rupees bonds, then that converted into the foreign currency on the basis of exchange rate. So foreign currency convertible bond issued outside India in foreign denomination or dollar denomination. But in the case of Masala Bond, Masala Bonds are issued in the form of rupee denomination. But if a company borrow 500 rupees from the foreign market, they also issue, they issuing the same amount in rupee in their market, or rather than local currency, they issued in Indian rupee. That's the basic concept of Masala Bonds. Then why it's so important? Because when foreign currency convertible bond issued, there is a possibility of incurring currency risk on that bonds. That means currency risk means the risk arising due to the depreciation of Indian rupee. So if a person want to borrow 500 rupees from a foreign market, and the exchange rate $1 is equal to 15, and then they have to issue $10 denomination bond in the foreign market. But if we issuing Masala Bonds, we can issue the same amount denomination bond, that means 500 Indian rupee bonds in the foreign market. The benefit of that is when the bond get matured, the issuer want to repay the loan amount or the full amount to the investor. If the exchange rate is not in the same rate in that time, like when bond issued, the $1 is equal to 15, and the time of redemption the $1 is equal to 100, then that time the issuer wants to pay 1000 rupees in respect of $10. So there is a extra or double principal amount can repaid by the repaid by the loan issuer. So there is a extra payment on exchange rate differentiation. So in Masala Bonds, this exchange rate differentiation or currency depreciation value is mitigated by masala bonds, where it's only issued in Indian rupees denomination, as like we issue 500 rupees in the foreign market of London as a 500 rupee Indian masala bond. Okay, that's the basic reason why masala bond is so important, and it's the cheapest source of fund available in the foreign market. Then, where does the concept of masala bonds origin? In 2013, the concept of masala bonds introduced by Raghuram Rajan, the former RBI governor. He introduced because that's the year when India faces lowest exchange rate in exchange with dollar, Indian rupee in exchange with dollar. That's why there is a huge difference between dollar and Indian rupee, and when the Indian entities are borrowing money from the foreign market, they have to pay extra rupees in respect of dollar. So he introduced the concept and bring money to the Indian government programs like infrastructural development programs, because in that's the time when India firstly faces the current account deficit. So firstly, the concept arised in 2030, but it implemented on 2015. IFC is the first International Financial Corporation is firstly introduced the masala bond in London Stock Exchange with a backup of World Bank. They raise 1000 rupees from London Stock Exchange, and then they independently issued in 2015 again masala bonds in the London Stock Exchange. Then HDFC is the first private company who issued masala bond in overseas market. In 2019, the Kerala government is also issued and brought 2150 crores in our country. So these are the webacks of masala bonds. Then how does the masala bonds mechanism work? There are two parts in the mechanism they are working. First one, the first part is on the time of issuance, and second part is on the time of redemption. When a masala bonds is newly issued in the foreign market, there must be two parties, settlement agent and calculation agent. When the calculation agent settle the all the terms and condition in related to issuance of masala bonds, and they calculate the foreign exchange rate in respect of what amount we want to issue in through the masala bonds. So they inform both issuer and investors about the masala bonds terms and condition and foreign exchange rate. Then the issuer transfer the amount which they want to buy from the investor transfer the amount to the settlement agent for the amount they want to purchase from the issuer. So the settlement agent convert the foreign currency into Indian rupee and transfer that amount to the issuer. Then the issuer issue the bonds in respect of the amount transferred to their account, and that's the first mechanism of masala bond. And when on the redemption, there should be a repayment of loan what they borrowed. So there is also 2 person in between, issuer and investor. They are one paying agent and one calculation agent. But the calculation agent calculate the amounts of bullets payment or terms and condition in respect of redemptions, and that information given to the investor and issuer, both investor and issuer. Then the issuer repay the principal amount plus interest as a bullet payment to the investor through the paying agent, and paying agent convert Indian rupee into the foreign currency. This is the mechanism of masala bonds. I hope you all get an idea about what is a masala bond. Then what its relation with KIFBI and masala bond, Kerala Infrastructural Investment Fund Board. is a board created for procurement of the fund for the development of infrastructural activities, procurement of fund for for infrastructural and development activity. And the, in 2019, they issued 2,150 crore Masala bonds at a coupon rate of 9.7% in London Stock Exchange, and they borrowed that fund or issued that fund through the private placement, not on the public placement. But private placement means only issuing a certain persons, not general public. So they issued the bond in private placement and bring 2,150 crore into our country, and that was the biggest borrowing done by an Indian state ever. Okay, or sub-sovereign entities. In Kerala is the first sub-sovereign entity who borrow fund from a foreign overseas market through Masala bond. There are so many controversies and issues about the issuance of Kerala government Masala bond, because it's issued in private placement, and the higher interest rate that higher coupon rate that the government paid, and so many things. Okay, but still Kerala government is the first state who issued Masala bonds in a foreign market. I'm going to winding up this section, and we will be back with another virtual teacher session. Okay. Thank you.